I was just looking around and I thought, we have a visitor over there. I didn't recognize Sister Lanita with a hat on. And so I was like, are we going to recognize the visitors this morning? It looked good in the hat. Praise the Lord. We're so happy to be here this morning and to see each one of you here. This is a blessed day, isn't it?
Yes.
I tell you, I'm happy because I see the sun shining.
Yes.
It rained for several days, and I was like, Lord, send the sunshine. I want to see some sunshine. And how many of you know He answers our prayers in a very timely manner? Yes, amen. Well, I'm standing here this morning. Sister Jessica has already said, how many of you really enjoy her giving the announcement? Isn't she good? Yes, amen. She's so animated in there. Yes, so we enjoy that. But she's already mentioned about the Founders Day, and I want to just ditto what she has said. I want to give kudos to Sister Pearl. Stand up, Sister Pearl.
Yeah.
Woo! Yeah. Amen. Who worked so hard and diligently coordinating everything. And as Sister Jessica said, things just don't happen by themselves. I came out one day and she was decorating the tables and all. And I was like, who's helping you? Well, there were some people that helped. She didn't do it all by herself. There was Brother Rod, Brother Al, and Brother Travis, and Sister Jessica, and there were some others. So we want to say thanks to Sister Pearl and company. Amen. We really appreciate it. The dinner was wonderful. How many of you enjoyed the dinner? Yes, yes, yes. And it was a few of you did. I hope everybody did. You just didn't respond. But we were glad to that it was such a beautiful occasion. And I didn't get to say very much on last week about our thank yous. And I would just like to say thank you to each one of you that contributed monetarily. Pastor and I don't see him in here at this time, but he's around someplace, I think. We are most appreciative for the efforts that you made. If you haven't given yet, there's still time. Just don't think, well, it's over with. We still will accept what you have to give. So, amen. We again, thank you so much for your support. And over the years, financial, prayer and ministry, and in every way, in your love, thank you so very much. I just wanted to say that. And see Sister Deborah coming in. So glad she's stooping down. She was a part of the committee, and she worked very diligently until Brother Beauty began to, until his health began to decline. So she was a part of that committee. We're so glad to see you today. All right, today is Mother's Day. And we're so happy to be here and to see you. Let me just say this. You see me with a white corsage on, thanks to Sister Janie Winston back there. And how many of you know what the white represents and what the red represents? Let me see your hand. A few of you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Some, it seems like most people over here do, some over there. Well, let me talk to the people that don't know. The white represent if your mother is deceased. The red is if you have a living mother. So if you look around and you have on a white one, my mother's deceased, but I was fortunate to have her almost 94 years. And so I was very, very blessed. And I trust that you are blessed whether your mother is living or whether she is deceased, you were blessed. Now, we know mothers come in all different shapes, forms, colors, and what have you. And I'm not going to go into that this morning because we have someone who is going to... I normally do a tribute, and I had one ready, but when she said she wanted to do something, I said, hey, I'm willing to yield. Hey, you know, I move out of the way of the old people for the younger ones. So at this time, I'm going to ask our daughter, Kimberly Thrower, to come forward. She has a presentation for the mothers, and how we're so thankful that God sent her back. She's been so creative with Black History Month, and you see her display back there. She's gonna tell you about that. because, you know, I'm not the creative one. She told me she wanted to do something. I said, go for it. Amen.
Amen.
Happy Mother's Day. A mother comes with all different names. Aunts who love, worry, and play. Teachers who help you, guide you, and set your aim. Sisters who listen and put your worries at bay. Grandmas with warm cookies, hugs, and prayers so you'll never stray. Yes, a mother does come with all kinds of names. I would like for all the mothers and surrogate mothers in the sanctuary today to please stand. Look around and give everyone a round of applause. Young mother standing, is it from 5 or 6 year olds? Thank you to all women for being a mother to someone's child, but most importantly, to his child. Usually on Mother's Day, most children honor their mothers with gifts or offer their services around the house, or make amends for not being able to spend quality time with her. I remember when we were young in grade school, we made little hearts and drove Happy Mother's Day or put flowers or glue and sprinkled, and that was our Mother's Day gifts. You and I, we didn't have any money as kids. So that was one way we remembered our mothers. For this special day, Sister Hill and I would like to share with all mothers and surrogate mothers small tokens from our hearts to yours. You'll notice on the display table behind you a Mother's Day tribute, which we just shared, a hand fan, a rose for each of you to take home with you after service today. Now, a bit of history about the hand fan. A hand fan induces airflow for the purpose of cooling or refreshing oneself. Generally, purpose-made handheld fans are shaped like a sector of a circle and made of thin material, such as paper or feathers, mounted on slats which revolve around a pivot so that it can be closed when not in use. Next to the folding fans, the rigid hand screen was also a highly decorative and desired object among the higher classes. Its purpose is different, since they are more cumbersome to carry around. They were mostly used to shield the lady's face against the glare of the sun or the fire. Archaeological ruins and ancient texts show that the hand fan was used in ancient Greece during services to drive insects away from the consecrated bread and wine. Its use died in Western Europe, but continues in the Eastern Orthodox and Ethiopian churches. In the 17th century, the folding fan was introduced from Japan. Simpler form fans were developed in China, Greek, and Egypt. Queen Elizabeth I of England can be seen to carry both folding fans decorated with pom-poms on their guard sticks, as well as the older style rigid fan, usually decorated with feathers and jewels. Thank you, Sister Hill. Wasn't that fan she was holding beautiful? Roses are among the most popular flowers sent to mothers on Mother's Day. Here are a few rose colors and their meanings as explained by Teleflor. That's a florist. Red is traditionally considered the rose for lovers. This strong color signifies passion. And as Sister Hill mentioned earlier, it's also symbolized mothers that are living. White is associated with humility and innocence. These roses would be good for religious figures in your life or the deceased mother. Yellow roses are a great symbol of friendship. Pink is traditionally symbolic of appreciation and admiration. Orange roses stand for enthusiasm and desire. Perhaps you have a new crush who happens to be a mother. These flowers would be a nice way to tell her what she means to you. So in closing, don't forget to choose from the variety of beautifully decorated fans in the back, one per mother and one per surrogate mother. And if you don't know what a surrogate mother is, I just kind of read it, mothers, aunts, teachers, who kind of step in the place for mothers who aren't no longer around or could be around, but they are a mother figure. Pick up your fan, your rose, and the Mother's Day tribute on your way out. Again, happy Mother's Day to all.
Thank you.
Well, happy Mother's Day, mothers, dad, dads, sons, daughters. Don't we have some beautiful moms in here?
Yeah, yeah.
Give them another hand, praise God.
Show her how much I loved her. Mother's Day.
mother's birthday. Whatever the day was, every day was her day. Whatever she needed, if I could get it, I got it for my mom. I just want to say, love your mom now while you can. Show her how much you love her. Take her out sometime. Give her now. Oh, she gave me my start.
Gave me my start.
I'm going to keep her in my heart.
Here in my heart.
About my mother
every day.
Oh yes I do, yes I
Enjoyed you, Brother Walter.